But I always knew I was going to be something great.
Steven Victor, this is for you, my nigga. Without further ado, roll the clip. First, I would like to say RIP to Pop Smoke, the Big Woo. You'll forever be missed. The smoke will never clear. That was cheesy as fuck, but it's true. Now, to start off, I don't really do videos like this. Well, I do, just not, I never do like professional rants type shit. Actually, this is the first rant I ever wrote on script. That's how pissed off I was. So if you could drop a like, it'd truly make my day. But without further ado, here's my video. I'm basically break it down to three or four parts. We have hit miss ratio, features, energy, or delivery. So without further ado, let's get this shit started. Keep in mind, I listened to the whole album head to toe, not one, two songs to hop on the computer and release my pocket pussy to the whole damn world. Here we go.
Hit or miss ratio.
The hit and miss ratio isn't as bad as I thought it would be. But see, that isn't the problem of Raw. The album is not that bad. Well, scratch that, the album's dog shit. If I was Pop Smoke, I'm sending Steven Vick to the Flossy and making him meet the woos. Not the woos, the woos. Nah, the woos, man. Stop playing. Alright, hit or miss ratio was a 9 for 20. Meaning that out of 20 songs, there were only 9 hits, giving it a total of 45%. That's a score based on songs alone. Songs like Top Shotta and Brush 'Em were completely ruined. I went into Top Shotta like this.
Oh shit, is that Top Shotta?
But then I was greeted to a sneak peek of a Umizoomi Mario Kart crossover. Like, what the fuck is this? Like, just listen to this sorry excuse for a song, okay? Just listen for yourself. Cause y'all be like, oh, I'm hating. Listen to this song yourself. Amina sounds like it was recorded as an end credit song for an off-brand animated Disney movie. What is this? I have a piece on the album Pop Smoke wouldn't even approve of. Does Pop Smoke even know Pusha T? Does he even know Pusha T? Like, what the hell? That ain't made no sense.
You gonna sit and tell me you let this nigga moan on a Pop Smoke album? How dare you? This monstrosity cannot go on for any longer. I'm tired. Go to the next feature, my nigga.
Now on to features. Features is probably the worst part of the whole 3 parts, we're being honest. I'm not gonna make this too damn long because I'm not trying to have a 3 hour long video on how bad the album was. Even though I actually didn't go on for that damn long about how Steven Vick
failed to put out this album.
I'm just gonna show you a video of how Pop feels about the industry. And you let me know if there should be damn near the entire universe of the industry on the damn song.
I don't fuck with niggas. If you notice why I don't do songs with niggas, my tape ain't have nobody on it because I don't fuck with niggas. I don't like niggas. I don't want to like niggas. I'm not into them. You know what I'm saying? You know, because niggas be envious.
Now, after listening to that, like I said, you could probably, if not, can tell Pop do not like, as he likes to call them, niggas. Don't talk to niggas. Don't like niggas. So why would the label put so many people on the album? Pusha T, Travi, not Travis Scott, Travi. The Dream? Who the fuck is The Dream? No disrespect, Pusha T, but if Pop was still alive, you was not getting no say-so on that damn album. On God, you wasn't. Not you either, Travi. The hell out of here with that shit, bruh. Some features I was really excited for, but like the rest of the album, I was sadly mistaken. I was just like, for instance, I was expecting Kanye to go straight Yeezus, Graduation, Family Business. I can keep going. I was expecting him to go crazy. This motherfucker gave me 3-4 words, said Brooklyn really loud, and cut the album off. Like, again, what the fuck am I getting into this? I just feel like the entire label used Pop Smoke's impact as a cash grab. Nobody on the album, nobody, except for a small few. I would say 21 Savage. There were a couple good features on the album. Like, I'm not gonna lie. And at the end of the day, it's not their fault that the producers failed to mix the things right. Like, 30 and Top and Brush 'Em was mixed terribly. I've seen 5-year-old SoundCloud rappers do a better job than that. Tighten up, my nigga. To call that a posthumous, I don't know how to approach it. To call that a posthumous album is downright disrespectful. They painted Pop as an industry rapper when he's not obviously an industry rapper. Like, he's not an industry rapper. Like, what the fuck? The album was supposed to be for fans, the real fans from New York City. This album sound like it's for his killers or niggas in LA. Most likely his ops. Like, did Steven Vick spend a whole summer with Tutu G's in them? Like, what the fuck is this? Like, did this nigga come out Wu-K? But the majority of my anger is let off. Monstrosity, Beast of Mankind, whatever Steven Victor's called. That nigga's a spawn of Satan, because ain't no way in hell that nigga approved this shit, bro. But with that being said, me, my fellow New Yorkers, my subscribers, my family, we have decided as a group, as a unity, to let off a message that Pop Smoke would gladly want you to take. Now, if you fuck with the video, like, comment, subscribe. I don't know if y'all want me doing a video like this. I don't do videos like this, but, you know, that's pretty much it. And, yeah, here's a message. And see if you hear this, fuck you.
Fuck you. Fuck the plane you flew in on. Fuck them shoes. Fuck those socks with the belt on it. Fuck your gay fairy faggot accent. Fuck them cheap ass cigars. Fuck your yuck mouth teeth. Fuck your hairpiece. Fuck your chocolate. Fuck Guy Ritchie. Fuck Prince William. Fuck the Queen. This is American, nigga. My president is black. My Lambo is blue, nigga. Now get the fuck out my hotel room. And if I see you in the streets, I'ma smack this shit out of you. Whoa.